Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about a request body template. I mean, this is an important aspect. We have already seen this kind of syntax, which is nothing but a body template mapping language which AWS provides. It is actually used to transform the payload body so that we can extract only whatever we need from the request body. So consider an example. Like here we are sending, let's go to Lambda. And from Lambda, while testing, we are sending this object. Let's say we have the nested object like book. And here we wanted to access name property from this. Okay, this is the nested object and I'm passing this. Now, if I want to extract the name property in the current situation, then what I have to do is I will do const, you can say book equal to event dot, here we have a lot of options, event dot book dot name. This is what I need to do. And here you can send the name, sorry, book name. Okay, we are extracting the name property from there, and now if I test it from the API gateway, then you should be able to get the name, which is JS, which is a string. Okay, this is working fine. Now coming to this API gateway or response body mapping template, we will start from here. So this is required when you want to transform the payload. You want to get only the required things from the JSON object. Okay, so this is required when you are just targeting only a particular attribute. You are getting a big JSON object, but you want to extract or you want to define a template for extracting the data. So here I created an application JSON, a new body template. And what I'm doing is I'm mapping it with the empty object. Now let's see what will happen if I do this. That means even if you keep this empty, then it will just forward whatever you are getting. But if you are making it as an empty object, and what will happen is it will just pass the empty object to us. And if we just try to test it now with the same object, then we should get null or some error because we can't access the property of name undefined, right? Event.book.name. The Lambda will throw an error. Okay, so how we can fix this? I mean, how we can define the transformation body template? So AWS provides the in its own internal language for defining these body templates, where instead of going through a whole lot of transformation like event.book.name, I can just try to directly get the event.name, right? Is it possible? If I run this currently, we will still get undefined because there is no name property directly. It will give null, right? So what we can do here is in the response body template, we will try to do some transformation. So here in the integration request of this, here if I talk about this transformation, I mean, it is the default one. We don't need the whole one. What we need is this is helper. This will help us to extract out the body JSON from the request body. Okay, we can just think about this for now. So it is just sending the body JSON to our Lambda. Instead of this, what we can do is we can set name, and it is internal AWS extraction language or body templating language. What you can do is body.json, it is actually representing request body. So here you can just put dot, and I think there is a book we have, and this should return the name property, right? And just now save it. Once we save it, we should be able to directly assign the name property to the Lambda event object. Right, event.name now should represent a book name. And if I test it now, yes, now we are getting the name property because we defined a response body template. Sorry, request body template, and we are able to do it. So you can actually customize it. There are many ways of writing this JSON object. It's not just about just extracting the request body. You can do it for the query parameter, request body templates. You can write, let's look into the documentation for this. So there are different body templates, and this is how you can access the different variables. Okay, authorizer errors and input dot body. Here, this is what we are using. This is giving us the request body, input, request parameters, request path. Okay. And the default, like if you want to get all the parameter mapping, this will also all give you. Like you can extract the name, request parameter name, and it is giving you the body. You can also do it like this. What it will give you, it will give you the body. And then from the body, you can extract it. So here, body should represent whatever you are sending. Okay, let's save it. Now you have to go back again and change the lambda. Here, event dot, so event is representing the same, book dot name. It should be event dot body. Wait a second, event dot body dot book dot name. This will now get longer because in an event object you have a body and then you have a book dot name. I just want to try this, not sure that we need to extract the this. Yeah, it is giving us the JS. That's correct. So we are getting just a book name. We are extracting out event as a body property. From that we are accessing book and name property. Okay, that's it guys in this video. Thanks everyone.